This morning, nearly 2,000 kids will go to their summer program at the Boys and Girls Club.
The goal of this is to prevent children from going down what they call the summer slide. KSHB 41 News reporter Charlie Keegan here to explain to us what that means. Charlie, I have school-age kiddos, and it's always a topic of what are we going to do to try and get them to crack open a book or do something good for their brain over the next 60 days. Just to stay where they were, absolutely right, and have some momentum going into next year.
Yeah, we talk about this learning loss that happens during the summer. When we talk about the summer slide, I want you to think about the slide at a playground, like where I am right here. And you start at the beginning of the summer way up here with all the knowledge you learned during the school. But as the summer goes along, you slide down and regress and lose some of that knowledge. So organizations like the Boys and Girls Clubs want to fight this, want to prevent this. I went to the Boys and Girls Clubs yesterday. Just this week, they've launched a summer enrichment program to really, like you mentioned, Taylor, get those kids to open a book, get them to talk about school again and keep up on all those things. This is a 9-week event that really focuses on reading and STEM, science and math. We had a chance to speak to one of the students participating, a 10-year-old, and he told me that the teachers here make all the difference.
I had this one teacher called Miss Sheba. We had snacks. She made food for us. We went to the gym a lot, and she was really fun.
So the Boys and Girls Club hires about 100 extra staff members like Miss Sheila to help out with their summer enrichment program every year. And it is full up. They have 100 extra staff members, about 2,000 kids spread out to 5 different Boys and Girls Clubs throughout the area. So they are all full, but they do have a wait list if you're interested in getting your child on that wait list, Lindsay and Taylor.
Yeah, Charlie, you said that this morning. So we want to give parents tips since they can't go to their program. What about parents who can't enroll? How can they prevent that summer slide?
Right. So we got some advice from Scholastic, that book fair company that we've partnered with in the past. They say encourage your students, your kids to read first and foremost, and read something that they actually find interesting. Also, do things like smart play that engage the brain in critical thinking or problem solving and puzzles, things like that. And then try something new. Get out and about. Go on a field trip. Go to a museum, a library, a historical site. That's one of the big tips that you can take advantage of over the summer. Because Lindsay and Taylor, we should still be having a little fun during the summer, right?